playing pitches at Clonkeen College. As you know, the Christian Brothers are planning to sell 7.5 acres of playing pitches belong to Clonkeen College. Seven members of the board of management have now been forced to take high court proceedings to try and prevent this sale from going forward. That will rob those 500 students and future generations of playing fields that they need and have in the past enjoyed. And really the question, Minister, is what are you going to do to help them secure the future of these pitches? Or are you just going to take a hands-off attitude and force them to have to go through very, very expensive legal proceedings with uncertain outcomes to try and save their pitches?
I'd like to thank Deputy Boyd Barrett for raising this. It's an issue that I know well about because Minister Mary Mitchell O'Connor indeed organised the deputation of which you were a member, and we have had frequent conversations about the issue since. The difficulty is the fields in question are owned by the Congregation of Christian Brothers, and the decision by the Christian Brothers, which is a private entity, to dispose of land owned by the congregation is a matter for them. My department understands that the Board of Management or members of the Board of Management are taking legal proceedings against the Congregation of Christian Brothers relating to the sale of the fields. My department has no role in such proceedings. I wish to clarify for the Deputy that the Congregation of Christian Brothers wrote to my department in early May in regard to the disposal of part of the lands at Clonkeen College, and it stated that this disposal was the subject of contractual arrangements between the congregation and a builder. The brothers indicated 7.5 acres of land currently licensed to Clonkeen College, together with IRS head offices which borders Clonkeen College, are involved in the sale.
I've asked you several parliamentary questions, and in the most recent one I asked you about this claim that Christian Brothers are making, which you've recycled in various answers, that there's a binding agreement, okay? And I asked you, can you give us the details of this so-called binding agreement? And in your response, you say, my department has not seen the contract for sale, okay? Case that is going on, I can't obviously comment on the details of it, but the Christian Brothers have indicated it will delay the sale, which suggests there isn't a binding contract and the sale is not complete, okay? So there is time to intervene. But the members of the Board of Management and the wider Clonkeen College community cannot afford to be raising the sort of money that's necessary to go to the High Court to secure these pitches. And what they and I wonder is, how can you possibly say a school that has massive public investment, where is paid for by the state, is somehow not your business, and it's a private matter for the Christian Brothers? I mean, it's bizarre. But facilities that are with the major public investment in them are going to be substantially degraded to the detriment of 570 students.
The position is that the congregation has informed the department that lands concerned have been sold, that the congregation has signed and exchanged legally binding contracts with the purchasers, and the congregation cannot reverse this transaction. Of course, if a legal challenge is made to those contracts, that is the subject which, as you say, you're not in a position to comment on, nor am I in a position to comment on such a challenge. But if a challenge is mounted to a contract, clearly it will be up for the courts to determine the matter. The position of my department is obviously where we invest in property, there is a lien on those properties, ensuring that they must be used for the purpose, the educational purpose, and that is true of anything that the state has invested in these properties, and they are protected. But this is a question of land that has been adjacent to the Clonkeen College. It has been in the use of students, but they, as the legal owners of it, have the right to dispose of that land. That is the legal position that I cannot alter.
You could alter it, for example, by putting a compulsory purchase order on it. Now, I know when I've asked you about this, you said your department can do that, but you can and do it to build schools by asking local authorities to compulsorily purchase the land. Now, I would suggest, Minister, you do that and save the Board of Management and all the wider Clonkeen Community College the hardship of having to raise vast amounts of money to go into an uncertain outcome in the High Court to save these pitches. And by the way, there is department investment in the pitches themselves. Those pitches were upgraded and department money went into that and into fencing and so on. And it is going to impact on the capacity of that school to deliver recreational and sports facilities, which matter, right? These aren't an optional extra in education. They're critical when you're talking about proper development of young people, about dealing with obesity, encouraging healthy exercise and so on. For these pitches to go and for you to stand idly by is unconscionable for every reason. In terms of your responsibilities as the Minister for Education for the education of these young people.
Minister, final response. The position is, you know, the patron, which is us in this case, has a responsibility, of course, to provide for the students in the school, and they are making provision, and I understand the Christian Brothers have made arrangements for transfer of some of the land, but they own other land which they have made a decision to dispose of. I'm not in a position to purchase that from them or to block that sale. This is a decision that they have made, and that we have no role in the proceedings that are now being taken by an entity to challenge that sale. I regret that that's the situation, that I can't give the deputy more reassurance.
Margaret, we move on to the final priority subject, Catherine Connolly.